1st of October. That's the effective date of the changes. Administratively, that's the first date that we had. That's been discussed with the union from since the day we began this stuff. We realized that we were going to be switching over. We agreed to do it 7 days after. The reason for that is not only the administrative issue of the time because of the 450 weeks not to have to all the time, but also because of given the opportunity for people that own the jobs right now, having the opportunity to take a look at them and see if they're second thing is, Inspector, this Saturday, as opposed to what I'm today, everybody's side chains being put back to 8 o'clock. Okay? That's not just in the building. All right? It's going to be done every amendment here in the building. All right? There will be some later, earlier start times in the city because of the mixture of businesses that they have that they get. But that will be put up today. Again, that was something that we've had a bunch of discussions about. We've been trying very hard now. And it's not necessarily going to be something that's going to be a permanent change. But right now, just so everybody understands, because there's a real misconception about function four. And it's important that you guys understand this. My IOP, which is an integrating operating plan, which is an agreement that I have with a plan that tells me what percentage of my mail I'm going to get on each trip. It says that I'm supposed to receive 70% of my work in letters and 50% of my work in class. On the 345 trip. That means I have to have that mail in here for those my clerks to work. My clerks don't have mail on the 345. They get zero. They may get 5%. They're getting no working mail. So they're getting all their mail. We're only supposed to get 5% on our last trip, which is at 7:15, 7:30. I'm getting 50-70% of my mail at that point. That's why everybody sees function four. They think that function four is not getting enough of their work done. You need to understand, it has nothing to do with function. It has to do with the way the plan's getting our mail. All right, if we can see that turn back around, just believe me, there is a supervisor here that wants everybody starting to make the play. There is an A supervisor here. It's not something that we're very, very excited about either. It's just bouncing up against that 1700 again. So there's a lot of, there's a lot of reasons for it. I want to make sure that will be posted today. If there's people within the unit that will have a later start time, or an earlier start time because of this makeup of the mail, only because of the makeup of the mail. At this point, we are not entertaining any special requests. All right, you speak to your supervisor if you have some sort of issue, some outside issue that you have an impact on, you need to speak to your supervisor. But there really isn't any entertaining of that going on right at this moment. But if you have a job that is a business route, a lot of business route, and you have a live volume on the mail here first thing in the morning that doesn't necessarily come from the Function 4 operation but comes to you directly from the plant, there'll be a possibility that that will stay at the time of the mail. Supervisors, we have people that hear Sky 8 o'clock already. Can you please make sure that they're aware of the change today and understand that as well as understand what the actual changes are October 1st? I'm only going to entertain a couple of questions because I've got a lot. I can go through this whole building. So Chris put his hand up halfway through. So I'm going to, you're all set? Yes, please.
You have an agreement with the plant and they're not honoring that agreement. Why don't they fix it?
We've said that same thing over and over again, and it's been, I don't know. I can't answer that. Nobody's making it happen. It's simple as that. I don't know how to explain that.
You didn't explain for the strips for today.
We're going to be doing those strips.
We are.